Hey y'all, up here at Pigeon Forge at the Rod Run at Quaker Steak and Lube, and I got a 68 Ford F100, kind of street truck, nice driver I think y'all are going to enjoy. Let me get the camera turned around, we'll take a quick look at it. What about that, right? Not a crazy custom. It's an F100, he's put some of the Ranger trim on it. I think just enough, he's kept it really clean. Wimbledon white. Got the Boss wheels on it. You know, and like I say, it's not over the top. But it's very clean, very straight, nice truck. And I know there's a lot of y'all that like drivers. And that's a nice driver. I like what he did with the Ford, too. I can't tell if that's black. It almost looks like it's a dark gray. But it's got a good stance. Like I said, didn't shave the handles, the drip rails, the fuel tank, the mirrors, nothing. Just, he said he wanted a driver. He's got other nice hot rods, and he said he just wanted to build a clean driver, and I think that's what he nailed there. And then he put the Ranger grill in it. I like that, too. Just gives it a little bit of color, you know? Now, Jody had the black and silver Ford truck over at Holcomb's we shot a few months back. And this one here, again, he didn't take it there. He just wanted a driver. Had somebody locally do the seat. And I think they did a fair job on that. It looks nice. And that's the original seat that came in the truck. Oh, I like what he did there with that hammered effect on the trim, right? That looks really nice. That's a nice little feature there. That's cool. I appreciate them all, you know what I'm saying? Stock, lightly modified, crazy customs. And this one here is just, like I say, it's a nice driver. It gives you that feeling like you could just go cruise it anywhere you wanted to, pull up to the home, up to Lowe's, and I don't know if you want to throw dirt back there. I don't know. I still wouldn't do that, but you know what I'm saying. You could take it to the home improvement store. And in the bed, you know, used a little bed liner-like material on the bottom of it, but the rest of it's smooth and painted, which, again, I think that's a nice effect. A lot of times people take the bed liner all the way up to the top of the bed, and that's a great breaking point, but I think it's nice to see them done like that, too. Looks good under here, Jody. What'd you do?
Well, we sort of kept it neat, cleaned up the fenders a little bit. It's got the power steering, power disc brakes on it. It's got a 351 Cleveland. Put the Holley 750 double pumper on it. Sort of left it for a good driver. Didn't put the electric fans or anything on it.
Did you do anything with the inner fenders or just kind of
Cleaned them up?
They was,
you know, stock fenders, inner fenders on it.
Just, and that's a 351?
351 Cleveland. Yeah. Uh-huh. Put a little mile cam in it.
How many horse do you think that is?
Don't really have it pinpointed down on there. Put the March runner system on it. Got vintage air.
Right. No, it looks nice.
Thank you.
Didn't hide anything or, you know, there again, you were telling me, just a nice driver truck, right?
Just keeping it clean. Got a C6 back in it, yep.
Okay. No, that's nice. What you did up under the hood and got everything looking right. Beautiful truck, brother.
Appreciate it too.
So there you go, from the Quaker Steak and Lube in Pigeon Forge, a 1968 Ford F100. Hope y'all enjoyed it.
See ya.